In my experience, my attention is absorbed in a realm where there is just infinite happiness, infinite joy, infinite light, infinite goodness, infinite love. And abiding in this transcendental level of reality, you are abiding in supreme happiness. Not an emotional happiness, not a pretense of happiness, of a me being happy, but being absorbed in the realm that is infinite joy, infinite happiness, without an ego attached to it. It is freedom from the ego. If you are attached to an identity, to this person, it's not that you stop being a person, but when you are no longer attached to being a person, and your attention is free to transcend mental perception, emotional perception, physical perception, and open into a new level of perception where your attention is absorbed in the transcendental reality, absorbed in supreme happiness. It is not that you become more peaceful, more blissful, more happy. It is that you become free of yourself. You become free of yourself. That does not mean you stop having a personality or anything. It's that your attention is no longer bound to it and can transcend it into the realm of supreme happiness. This has happened through many years of meditation and spiritual practice, and through immersing myself in Shakti. It has not happened because I have found a shortcut, or I didn't do the work, or I took some drug, or I read a certain book. Certain things may happen along the way. Certain books may present themselves to you. Certain teachings may help you. But that does not escape you from having to do the work, from having to day in, day out meditate, do the spiritual practices that move your attention out of mental perception, out of emotional perception, out of physical perception, into consciousness. or into devotion, into love, into peace, into bliss, into goodness, into silence. And you have to keep giving yourself to silence, giving yourself to bliss, giving yourself to consciousness, however you're realizing it at the moment. You have to do the work. You have to go through it. You have to become free of yourself. And it seems that on this path we suffer. We go through periods of suffering, of challenges, to become free of ourselves. Because when we're happy, we don't want to be free of ourselves. When things are going the way we want them to be, we don't want to be free of ourselves. But when your back is against the wall because you are challenged in ways that you cannot take anymore, then you willingly become free of yourself. You willingly surrender yourself into peace, into consciousness. And it is not that you learn to surrender. I mean, this is what happens. You learn to surrender yourself into peace, into consciousness, into bliss, until happiness rolls around again, and then you come out of it. And that's natural, that's normal. But the real lesson here, the real direction, is to direct your attention into peace, into awareness, into bliss, into silence, into whatever is beyond the mind. And abide in it, and make that your reality. Abide in that to the point where that is your reality, where that reality dominates your experience. That, in my experience, is the path. What techniques or practices you do are maybe unique to you, yeah? But you give yourself to them. And in this way, you become free of yourself. You learn eventually that there is no permanent happiness in the physical reality, that nothing in the physical reality will permanently fulfill you. You come to this realization on your own through your journey, through doing the work, through going through the sufferings. And then you learn to abide in peace, and peace becomes bliss, and bliss becomes oneness, it becomes isness, and then it becomes nothingness, and then it becomes joy, it becomes your perception opens into the reality that is infinite happiness, that is supreme happiness, supreme joy. That realm, that is all there is. It says fire cannot burn it, water cannot wet it. It is untouchable. It is transcendent of everything. It remains in the unmanifest. The unmanifest reality that is infinite joy. It is not that the reality is not manifested. The reality is the unmanifest. The reality that is divine. The reality that is enlightenment. You don't get it and you don't attain it. It doesn't come to you. you become free of yourself and abide in it. That's my experience. You learn to abide in the transcendental reality. And as egos, we look for shortcuts. We look for the next teaching, the next therapy, the next drug that'll just get us there. That's why people love taking drugs. It's instant gratification, instant high. Destroys your life, but at the moment it makes you high, so it doesn't matter. That kind of happiness is self-destructive. But awakening into this joy is the opposite. That it just rains goodness. It just shines goodness in every aspect of your life, in the physical and the emotional. In the mental, it just shines the most exquisite divine goodness imaginable. But to get there, you can't look for shortcuts, because that's the ego. You have to surrender that ego that is looking to get something, that is looking to give $1 and get $2 back. When you give yourself fully to this, when you become free of yourself, when you become free of yourself, the doors to the infinite open. The only thing outside of practice, outside of doing the real work authentically, that is extremely helpful is Shakti, is this transmission of enlightenment, this blessing of the divine. In my life, I've been obsessed with this transmission of bliss. I have been fallen in love with it, addicted to it, obsessed with it, absorbed in it. Because when you feel this bliss, through my music, through these videos, through meditating with me, when you feel this Shakti, then instantly you know what I'm talking about. Instantly you have found what you are looking for at a certain level. And by giving your attention to it, by becoming obsessed with it, by loving it, by giving your attention to it, that becomes your reality. It takes you beyond yourself into joy. A loved one was telling me earlier today that she sits and breathes deeply and she feels ecstasy. And I was saying, that's a gift. That's a gift from the divine. That's a gift from enlightenment. And then you give your attention to that ecstasy. You immerse your attention into it. And that takes you out of being bound by the physical, mental, emotional experience. It's a doorway into transcendence. but that's not really a shortcut in the sense that, I mean, yes, it's going to save you a lot of time if you're just trying to meditate on your own. But if you're listening to my Shakti CDs like Pure Radiance, Infinite Sky, Shakti Silence, and your attention is in the bliss that you feel, then you still have to give yourself to the bliss. You can't remain in the ego and saying, I'm getting this, I'm getting more, I'm getting more, I'm getting more, I'm getting more. So rather, you give yourself to the bliss. You give yourself to awareness. You give yourself to peace. I promise you this is worth it. I remember early on when I was 20. At Bennington College. Sitting in the dark in my dorm room meditating. Not really feeling much peace, but giving it my all. And outside, just across the lawn, there was a big party happening. And I could hear my friends laughing and drinking and having a merry time. And I was inside in the dark in my dorm room meditating, because the truth was the party wasn't so interesting to me anymore. There was something else. That I wanted much more. And it is that. It is sitting in your dark room and meditating and doing the work, getting Shakti. Day in and day out, and it softens you. It softens the sense of me. It softens that hard, contracted sense of me. Takes you to the divine, takes you to the realm of infinite happiness. So that's more than enough talking. I hope you've enjoyed the video. And I hope you feel a little bit of what I'm talking about, what I'm expressing. Thank you. Much love. Much love to you.